A fascinating book on Lisa Miller. Lisa Miller, Only One Mommy. We're going to be talking about it today and talking to its author, Rena Linda Valtzen. I'm Matt Staver, founder and chairman of Liberty Council. Joining me is Rena Linda Valtzen, the author of this book, The Lisa Miller Story, Only One Mommy, who is also special counsel for Liberty Council. And Rena, we were talking yesterday about this book, and I want to just go through some of the chapter titles. It talks about Lisa's childhood years. An unhealthy childhood led to unhealthy relationship choices. Chapter 3, What Led Lisa to Choose the Homosexual Lifestyle. The Consequences of Lisa's Choice to Enter the Homosexual Lifestyle. Understanding the Interstate Custody Battle. That's part of the legal issue that ultimately came about. Helping Others Make the Choice to Leave the Homosexual Lifestyle. Overcoming Her Addiction, speaking about the addictions that she had at that time. And how homosexuality impacts our children, understanding how the homosexual rights movement affects you and your loved ones. And then a few parting thoughts. But it's a great book, Lisa Miller's Story, Only One Mommy, and it is part of our new publication of New Revolution Publishers. We talked yesterday about how she went through difficult childhood times, then went through a marriage after high school and while she was, I think, through college. Mm-hmm. And then that failed, how her mother died, and she ends up in AA, where she ultimately encountered Janet Jenkins, and they entered into this lesbian relationship. We talked at the end of the program yesterday about the change that you saw in Lisa Miller. Now, tell us a little bit about the issue of the homosexuality that she struggled with. You know, sometimes people put that on a different scale of sins, of all sins. But tell us about what she experienced with and what your message would be to people into the church.
Sure. And that's an important message. I think we see in the churches today a few things happening. One, either you have churches, unfortunately, accepting it as okay and it's not sinful conduct, or you have churches that just don't know what to do with it or afraid of it or view it as some sin that's sort of up there as the worst sin, and they relegate it to, well, I can't help you with that issue. Only if you have struggled with same-sex attractions can that person help you. And Lisa actually saw that. She had pastors tell her that we can't counsel you. I don't understand same-sex attractions. You need to find somebody who's been through that. And that really prevented her from moving along in her walk with Christ. And so I think it's really important, and Lisa tells the story through here as well, that you know, struggling with same-sex attractions is not unlike so many things that so many of us struggle with. When I saw some of the root causes of this, insecurity, lack of identity of who we are, particularly who we are in Christ, you know, life issues that impacted us, we all struggle with those, and we all turn to different things that are sin issues. She happened to turn to a lifestyle of homosexuality. And so I think it's important for the church to understand that anyone can help someone struggling with same-sex attractions. You just need to meet them where they're at, and you need to understand these root causes and help them gain a new identity in Christ and to understand that they can change through the power of Jesus Christ. But we can't view it as sort of the unpardonable sin, the worst sin. It is like other sins. It's a sexual sin. We need to deal with it that way. But the church needs to outreach to those struggling with this.
I know in knowing Lisa Miller for a number of years up until 2009 when we last saw her, the fact of the matter is that she was a – and her daughter, Isabella, is just an amazing little girl. But she was so positive and optimistic, and you would never have known by talking to her that she had come through such a difficult childhood and college years and then, of course, the failed marriage. Because it was like she was a new person. But she came through a very difficult childhood. She came from what I would term a dysfunctional family with a very weak mother who ultimately nevertheless died. And she still loved her mother even though she was a weak figure in her life. She had a lot of hurts that she went through, a lot of personal struggles, addictions to try to satisfy that inner emptiness that she had experienced through the early part of her life and ended up going into a lesbian lifestyle, realizing, of course, that wasn't the answer and and really had her life changed radically by the power of Jesus Christ. Now, I know that there are some people, particularly on the left, that say, well, homosexuality is innate, it's born in you, and you can't change. Well, Lisa Miller is an example of somebody who completely left the homosexual lifestyle through the power of Jesus Christ.
Yeah, and that's an important thing to understand, because that's the message our kids are being taught in schools. They're being raised that way, and we're not countering that in the church, and we need to counter it. There are too many people who have left the homosexual lifestyle for the message to be out there that you're born this way and can't change. We're all born with a sin nature. We're all have tendencies to do things we shouldn't do, but through the power of Jesus Christ, we can change, and she did change, and her life did change, sometimes day by day relying on Jesus Christ, but she changed through the power of Jesus Christ.
And, you know, I think the message that has come there from these people that are pushing a homosexual agenda that you cannot change is a very destructive and damaging message, because there's a lot of people who may be struggling with same-sex attractions. They don't want to act on the same-sex attractions, or somebody who's in the actual lifestyle and acting out on it but do not want to continue there. And if somebody tells them, you have no hope to change, that is you, and any type of change is going to be harmful for you, you're really dooming them to a lifestyle that can be very destructive.
Yeah, and it's important to mention there, too, we're not talking about that we have to go out and actively try to change everybody who's involved in a same-sex relationship. We're talking about people who God is really prompting them to want to leave this lifestyle. They know it's not right for them. They should get help. They should be entitled to have help. And so we're not seeking to change everybody. We'd love if everybody did change. But in this situation, she was entitled to have help from pastors, from counselors, to help her live a lifestyle that she knew was what God wanted her to live.
What would you say is the central core message of the Lisa Miller story?
I'd have to say there's more than one. Certainly the hope of a life changed. People need to hear that message. She writes, there's a chapter in here that she specifically addresses to people with some things that she'd written me for me, that she knows what you're struggling with. She knows what they're struggling with and what they need to do to leave that lifestyle. So that's the first one, hope. Secondly, encouraging churches to take action, because we have to. If we want to turn this culture around, churches have to get on board and motivated to changing lives. And third, it really is an awareness. People need to know what's taking place in this culture, in our schools. And so I have two chapters dedicated to that as well, because you need to know what you're fighting and up against.
You know, and I don't think most people realize the aggressiveness in the zero-sum game that really is part of the homosexual agenda. And it is very anti-liberty, very anti-religious. They literally would rather have you be shut down in your employment, in your business, in your licensing, in anything that you do if you do not accept the lifestyle. Just simply saying that you believe marriage is the union of one man and one woman is considered by some to be very hateful. It is incredible the extent to which there is an attempt to shut down, and I think people need to be aware of the implications of the homosexual agenda.
Yeah, and if you're not aware of that, the two chapters detail specifics and with references of what's taking place around the country in our schools and the agenda to get our kids. Because if they get the kids and get them on board with the message that you're born this way and can't change and this is normal, you're going to change our future for the negative.
Well, especially when you have, say, boys that typically go through the development of maleness, and they typically bond more with boys and not girls early on, and eventually as they grow, they become attracted to the opposite sex. But during that time where they're really bonding with each other and boys hanging around boys, if you now start to suggest to them that there's some kind of sexual component or orientation to that, you can literally push them, as Lisa was pushed, into a homosexual relationship.
And you deprive them of that necessary positive bonding experience with other boys at that age. So you've done harm in two different ways by pushing them into a homosexual lifestyle.
And the same thing with girls. I mean,
yes.
You see girls that hugging, holding hands that boys won't do. Just as friends, nothing sexually about that. But now if you start to sexualize that and eroticize that, you can ultimately push them in a situation where they don't want to be and should not be. Yes. Well, thank you, Rena Linda Valton, for being here. The book is called The Lisa Miller Story. The Lisa Miller Story, Only One Mommy, about Lisa Miller. I strongly encourage you to get a copy of this book. It's published by our New Revolution Publishers. For a contribution of $20, we'll send this to you. Call Liberty Council right now at 1-800-671-1776, or go to the website at lc.org. You can order this right there online at the Liberty Council website, lc.org. Go to the online store. With the holidays coming up, especially for Christmas, this is a great book to read during the time that you have some free time at the end of the year. I would encourage you to do so. It is a powerful testimony and story about hope and change how Lisa Miller was ultimately receiving hope and changed from the lifestyle through the power of Jesus Christ. And also, you ought to be aware of this agenda as well. It's called The Lisa Miller Story, Only One Mommy. Go to lc.org today.